Okay. Good evening, dear ladies. I would like to bless all of us, Bezrat Hashem, that we will all have the zchut to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Machmim Moim Bimrabi Amen Amen Eliyahu Navi Eliyahu Tishpi Eliyahu Giladi Bimrayim Unushech David Eliyahu Navi Zachur Latom. And may we all have the zchut to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi Bimrabi Amen Amen Kain Ban Mushuv Adonai Tzion Natata Kum Tarachem Tzion Ki Et Lechanena Kiva Moeda Shivenu Adonai Elecha Venashuv HaChadesh Amenu Kekedem. And may we all have the zchut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle, and may we all have part in Eretz Yisrael. בסייעתא דשמיא, the שיעור is לעילוי נשמת רבי חיים יוסף בן דוד ורחל, עליו השלום, תהי נשמתו צרורה בצרור החיים, זכותו תגן עלינו. לעילוי נשמת דוד בן אפרים, עליו השלום, תהי נשמתו צרורה בצרור החיים. לעילוי נשמת אלחננאל מרדכי בן רחל, עליו השלום, תהי נשמתו צרורה בצרור החיים. לעילוי נשמת יהודית פרל בת אורית, עליה השלום, תהי נשמתה הצרה בצרור החיים, ולעילוי נשמת מלכה בת אברהם, עליה השלום, תהי נשמתה הצרה בצרור החיים. And בסייעתא דשמיא, to all the souls that don't have anybody to say for them Kaddish, so may they be zocher with all of us, בעזרת השם, ברכם תערם מחמצת קדחה תמיד גמלם, and רפואת הנפש, רפואת הגוף, the health mentally and physically to כלל ישראל and to the whole world, and repentance, בעזרת השם, תשובה from עומק הלבב, from the bottom of our hearts to us, כלל ישראל and the whole world, בעזרת השם. And among them is Rabbi Eliezer, a Kohen ben Dvorah, may he have refuah shlema bezrat Hashem, and Anatza bat Yafa, refuah shlema, Chaya, Idit Yudit bat Rachel, Besiata Dishmaya bat Yachaya, Marina bat Rachel, Rachel Chaya Tonya bat Rut, and Mordechai ben Rivka, and Yona Batsara Zohara, Rachel Bat Kamar Levana, and everybody that needs refuah shlema from Aleph to Taf Bezrat Hashem. And all the ones that are healthy, may Hashem contain their health mentally and physically, Bezrat Hashem. Veshem Hashem Naseh Venatzlech, Enon Bilvado, Hashem Sfatai Tiftach Ufi Yagiti Latecha. Okay, dear ladies, we are a week and a half before Pesach, which is a big thing. This Shabbat is Shabbat Vayikra. The next Shabbat is Shabbat HaGadol, because Motzei Shabbat, when Shabbat ends, it's Pesach starts. So we are going to go through Halachot for Pesach B'Siyata Dishmaya, and I'm very excited. Every time that I need to give the Halachot, every year we do it together. All of the Chagim, before the Chagim comes, we sit down and do the Halachot together. But it's always very exciting, and Hashem Yiten Lanu Beracha V'Hatzlacha Bezrat Hashem. First of all, Chag HaPesach. Chag HaPesach, we always bless each other, Pesach Kasher V'Sameach. Always. And our sages say, why do we say Pesach Kasher? Because Pesach is on the month of Nisan, which is the head of all of the months. And that's why it includes, when we say Pesach Kasher, that Hashem will protect us in all of the holidays that are supposed to come. You remember we spoke that the month of Nisan is the first month of the year by the Torah. So look at this, Pesach Kasher, a kosher Pesach. The pay for Pesach is for the holiday, the high holiday of Pesach and of Purim. You see, Pesach and Purim, both of them start with a pay. The Samech of Pesach is for the holiday of Sukkot. The Chet of Pesach is for Chanukah. The Chaf of Pesach, of Kasher, is for Kippurim, Yom HaKippurim, the Atonement Day. The Shin B'Siyata Dishmaya is for Shavuot, and the Reish is for Rosh Hashanah and Rosh Chodesh. I didn't write it over here, but also for Rosh Chodesh, for the first day of the month and for Rosh Hashanah. So all of the holidays are included in Pesach Kasher. So when we bench each other and say Pesach Kasher, we bless each other Pesach Kasher, we are blessing the whole year, the whole holidays of the year, Bezrat Hashem. B'Siyata Dishmaya, the month of the name of the holiday Pesach has also three more names. It is called Chag HaPesach, the high holiday of Pesach. It is called Chag HaAviv. It's the holiday of the spring, because it's in the spring. It's called Chag HaMatzot, the holiday of Matzot, the matzah that we eat, and Chag HaChirut. It's the holiday of independence, that which means that we became free, free people. So it's called Chag HaPesach because Hashem skipped the houses, B'siyata Dishma, of the children of Israel on the 10th plague, which was the killing of the firstborn, when Hashem told the children of Israel, we spoke about it, to take a sacrifice, to take a sheep and to tie it to the Yud and the 10th of the month of Nisan to tie it, and then before they went out of Egypt, it was on Shabbat, and to tie the sheep, 1 year old sheep, male sheep without a defect, to tie him to the leg of the bed, and after 4 days that he's crying, this is one of the things of the Shabbat Agadol, because that on that Shabbat, you know that the Egyptians were worshipping the constellation of Aries, which is sign is sheep, and they heard the sheep crying and they couldn't do anything. Angels were protecting the children of Israel, and Hashem wanted the children of Israel, because they were in 49 gates of impurity, he wanted them to do sacrifice from themselves to show the bitachon, the confidence that they have in Hashem, in order that he can take them out of Egypt. So there were two things to do. One, bedamai chayi, bedamai chayi. In your blood you're going to live, in your blood you're going to live. It's written in the Agadah, two bloods. Blood, one is the blood of the sacrifice of Pesach, and the other one is the blood of circumcision, because except for the tribe of Levi, all of the children of Israel were not circumcised in Egypt. So then, in order to eat from the sacrifice of Pesach, they had all of them to be to have Brit Milah, to be circumcised. So these two bloods, the blood of circumcision and the blood of the sacrifice of Pesach, both of them showed emunah and bitachon, faith and confidence in Hashem. And with this B'siyata Dishmaya, Hashem took us out of Egypt. So B'siyata Dishmaya, Chag HaPesach, that Hashem skipped the houses. It comes on because of two things that happened on Pesach. One, that Hashem skipped the houses of the Jewish people. And you remember he told them to put blood on the mezuzah on both sides of the door. And why did he tell them to do that? Because Hashem doesn't need a sign. But Hashem went with destructive angels. And the destructive angels do not distinguish between people who sinned and people who sinned less. So righteous people and people that are not righteous, because even a righteous person has a sin. King Solomon says about it, "Ki lo yeh tzadik baretz asher yaseh tov velo yichta," that there won't be a righteous person on this earth and this land that will do good and won't have a sin. Even Moshe Rabbeinu, zchuto tagen aleinu, Hashem told him, "You 6 things you did that weren't in my will." So if Moshe Rabbeinu had 6 things that he did not in the will of Hashem, and he wanted to protect the children of Israel by doing this, v'siyata d'shma'al achat kamaf v'chama, furthermore us. So he told the children of Israel, because I'm sending the angels of the plague to go and to kill the firstborns of the Egyptian, for the firstborn that is in the palace, that is on the throne, to the firstborn that is in the dungeon. So b'siyata d'shmaya, because of that, we had to make sign for the destructive angels, and the Egyptians that were afraid of Hashem put their firstborns in the houses of the Jewish people, but into those houses Hashem went in and he killed the firstborns of the Egyptians in the houses of the Jewish people. So dear ladies, this is one thing, that's why it's called Pesach, because he skipped the houses of the Jewish people. And the second thing, it's Korban HaPesach, the sacrifice of Pesach that he told them to put, and it was on Shabbat HaGadol, and they had big miracles that nobody touched them. So Baruch Hashem, this is why it's called Chag HaPesach. Chag HaAviv, the holiday of spring, because this holiday is in the spring, Baruch Hashem. Don't forget to say Birkat HaIlanot, the blessings of the trees. Don't forget B'siyata D'shmaya, to search for 2 trees that that have flowers, that started their blossoming, and to say Birkat HaIlanot. The third name is Chag HaMatzot. Chag HaMatzot, it's because the children of Israel started to prepare bread and they didn't let it rise. It was a matzah and they went quickly out of Egypt. And because they had faith and confidence in Hashem, this is called Chag HaMatzot, on their merit, that this is what they did. And then Chag HaChirut, that we became a free nation, a nation that was in slavery 210 years, we became a free nation. So this is Chag HaChirut. There's a very nice thing, V'siyata Dishmaya, we know. We know V'siyata Dishmaya, that it's written in Shir HaShirim, Ani LaDodi VeDodi Li. We always, this is for the month of Elul, we always say, Ani LaDodi VeDodi Li. I'm for my beloved, and my beloved is for me. Which means I'm for Hashem, and Hashem is for me. V'siyata Dishmaya. So we know that Hashem, on the tefillin of Hashem, b'siyata d'ishmaya, it's written, Mi ke'amcha Yisrael go'echad ba'aretz, who is like your nation Israel, the children of Israel, one nation in the land, and the children of Israel sanctify the name of Hashem and unite it when they say, Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, which means, listen, Israel, the children of Israel, Hashem is our God, Hashem is one. So it says, this is Ani LeDodi VeDodi Li. This is in a sense, I'm for my beloved and my beloved is for me. Because look, inside that the Torah, the Chumashim, in the Chumash, it's written Chag HaMatzot. The name of the holiday is Chag HaMatzot, the holiday of Matzot. But b'siyata d'ishmaya, when we look at the Gemara and Talmud, the Talmud is not, there's no Masechet Matzot, there's Masechet Psachim. So a question is, the sages say, why this is Masechet Psachim, and in the side, the Chumash, inside the Torah, it's written Chag HaMatzot. So Hashem wanted to give credit to the children of Israel for their belief and confidence in Him, so He called the holiday Chag HaMatzot, because the children of Israel did not wait for a minute in a hush. They went out of Egypt. They didn't wait that the bread will rise. They ate it as a matzah because they had confidence in Hashem. They did two acts of real confidence. The one, the circumcision, and the other one is taking the korban of Pesach, the sacrifice of Pesach. And with these two bloods, b'siyata d'ishmaya, Hashem said, with this confidence that they showed me, even though they were in 49 gates of impurity, but they showed me they weren't even ready. I told them they just packed everything and went out. So in this, I'm going to call b'siyata d'ishmaya, this holiday, on their merit, which is Chag HaMatzot, the holiday of Matzot. And the children of Israel want to show the merit of Hashem, the big miracles that He did for us, by b'siyata d'ishmaya, calling it Pesach. And this is why the Talmud is, we have in the Talmud Masechet Psachim, in the Mishnah, in the Talmud Masechet Psachim. And why? Because we want to show how Hashem loves us, and He skipped it on the 10th plague that He gave on the Egyptians. He skipped the houses of the children of Israel, Pesach. So this is the unity between Hashem and the children of Israel, in the sense of Bezrat Hashem, I'm for my beloved, and my beloved is for me, Bezrat Hashem. So this is beautiful in the name of the Chag. Furthermore, B'siyata d'ishmaya, the four mitzvot in the holiday of Pesach, two mitzvot, B'siyata d'ishmaya, is from our sages. And this is eating matzah. It's from the Torah. V'igatet lefanecha, and you have to tell, you read the Agadah, and to tell your children that they will know the miracle that happened to the children of Israel in Egypt. B'siyata d'ishmaya. And then another two mitzvot that we have from our sages, eating maror, to eat maror. And the other one, the four kosot, the four cups of wine, b'siyata d'ishmaya. All four mitzvot is parallel to Yud Kei Vav Kei, the name of Hashem, b'siyata d'ishmaya, the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, and the name of Adnut, and the name of repentance, tshuva be'ezrat Hashem. We continue b'siyata d'ishmaya, and This is a very special, this year is a very special Shana, a year, because Motzei Shabbos is Pesach. So, you know that on Erev Pesach, there's Tanit Bchorim. There's a fast of the firstborns. So this year, the fast of the firstborns will be on Yudbet, on the 12th of Nisan, which is Thursday. Next week, Thursday, the firstborn sons are going to have Ta'anit. They will fast. Usually, they end the Masechet in the Mishnah, and then they have a Seuda. And by this Seuda, they go out of the fast, so they don't have to fast. But it will be on Thursday. Furthermore, B'siyata Dishmaya, Thursday night, because Erev Pesach, the eve of Pesach is Shabbat. So we can't do Bdikat Chametz on Shabbat, and we can't do, which means it's Friday night is already Shabbat. We can't do on Shabbat Bdikat Chametz, the checking of Chametz, and then on Shabbat itself to burn the Chametz. So it goes back one day. So Thursday night, we do Bdikat Chametz. On Thursday night, we do the Bdika. On Friday morning, we do Bi'ur Chametz. We do the Bi'ur Chametz on Friday morning, but on Shabbat, which is the eve of Pesach, after we finish the second Seuda, and when we finish the second Seuda, we then take all, we'll speak about it in a minute, we take all of the perurim, all the crumbs that we have, everything that we have, and we flush it in the toilet, or we put it in the garbage and take the garbage out in order that it won't be in our house, in our territory, B'siyata Dishmaya, and then we say Kol Chamira, that we say in the burning of the Chametz, because what happens is that when we burn the Chametz, we still have Chametz because we have Shabbat. So in Shabbat we have three meals. So B'siyata Dishmaya, we burn the Chametz on Friday, and don't forget to do Mechirat Chametz, to sell the Chametz. So B'siyata Dishmaya, we sell the Chametz. We can sell the Chametz until 9 o'clock in the morning on Friday. Friday morning, 9 o'clock. Better to do it Thursday night to sell the Chametz. You can do it online. You can do it with your rabbis. I sent you B'siyata Dishmaya on the WhatsApp. The halachot, the Jewish laws in Hebrew and in English. I already sent it to you about what we are going to do in these days, and especially on Shabbat with our Sudot, the meals of Shabbat. So if you have it in Hebrew, we send it in the WhatsApp in Hebrew and in English. And also I send you from Chabad, B'siyata Dishmaya, selling of the Chametz. Please sell the Chametz. If you forgot to sell the Chametz, you cannot use the Chametz after Pesach. So B'siyata Dishmaya, even if you go to, you're leaving the house, and you're not going to stay in the house for the whole Pesach, you have to sell the Chametz. So dear ladies, please don't forget to sell the Chametz next week, Thursday night. If you forgot, until 9 o'clock in the morning approximately on Friday morning, you can still sell it. So don't forget to sell the Chametz. B'siyata Dishmaya, we are coming to the Seuda. I'm reminding you that Kol Chamira, on the burning of the Chametz, we are going to do after the second meal of Shabbat. So we are coming to the Seuda Bezrat Hashem. Friday night, we still have Chametz, and we are obligated in the meals, the first meal and the second meal, to eat it with Lechem Mishneh, which means to have bread. So usually there are three solutions. The best one is the first one that I'm giving you now, B'siyata Dishmaya, is to use pita. Do you know what pita is? It has less crumbs. Or to have rolls, small rolls that have shiur, that we can eat two small rolls. I know that that B'siyata Dishmaya, all of the bakeries, they will prepare small rolls or pitot, buy pitot to see that you can do the motzi on the pitot, and you know what, and don't cut it with a knife, because us, the Sfaradim and Yemenite, we botzea et alechem, the challah, but the Ashkenazim, they cut it with a knife and it makes more crumbs. So this Shabbat B'siyata Dishmaya, you just tear it with your hand, it's less crumbs, and then you say hamotzi and you eat from it. So there are three options to say to do the motzi. One is to take pitot, mamash pat, lechem, pitot or rolls. The second one is to have matzah, that we make it matzah shira, it's egg matzah, which means to take an egg matzah that is considered as a matzah, that we don't say a motzi upon it, but we say a mezonot. But if you eat a shi'ur, which means like a, I think like four, like three matzot together, egg matzah, then you can say a motzi. Or when you decide that you are doing a suda over this, then you say a motzi. The third thing, besiyata dishmaya, is to take a matzah and to make it, to take a matzah and to make it a matzah mevushelet. Just a minute, I have to find a cooked matzah, which means you put it in a soup, you make it a cooked matzah, so it doesn't have the taste of a matzah anymore. Because you know why we can't eat matzah on Shabbat, because we need to love the mitzvah, and the only time we can eat the matzah is only when we do the seder. So Shabbat we have to eat pat, but if it goes out of the rule of pat, you can eat it. So dear ladies, if it's matzah mevushelet, there's no caution of chametz over here, because it's not chametz. But if it's egg matzah, it's considered like chametz. So everything that we do, we need to do like we eat a challah, which means we need to take all the crumbs, to throw it into the toilet and flush the water, or to take it out and put it outside in a garbage can that doesn't belong to us, so it's not in our property. B'siyata dishmaya. The best thing is to take pat. Now there are people who eat it in the porch, which means they do netilat yadayim, they do the kiddush outside with netilat yadayim, and they eat a motzi, they eat it with salads. Then they go into there, they take all the crumbs out of themselves, they go inside the house, and they eat, everything is kosher in the house, and they eat everything, all of the cooking and everything that is all the meal that you have for Shabbat will be kosher for Pesach. So everything that is not kosher is outside the house, or there are people that have in their basement a kitchen, so maybe over there you can eat it and do over there the motzi, and then you go into the living room and over there you continue the suda, and then you finish. So there are people who finish it in the place that they did the motzi, so they do Birkat HaMazon over there, and there are people who say that we have a kavana to continue the suda in the house, and we'll do the Birkat HaMazon in the house. So besiyata dishmaya, it depends how you fix it. Remember that if you're sitting and eating a meal for Shabbat from all the pots and containers of Pesach, we have to be very cautious to see that it doesn't touch any chametz, because it's Shabbat, and Motzei Shabbat is already the Seder. So you have to be cautious that nothing touches a chametz. Furthermore, b'siyata dishmaya, on the second day, we daven shacharit early, in order that we have to, around 10:30, to finish with the chametz. So which means we have to have suda shnia, the second meal. And we have the same thing as on Friday night, on the first meal. So we have to do the meal, and after that, to get rid of all of the chametz, v'siyata dishmaya, the same way that like we did on the first suda. And when we do that, we say kol chamira v'chamira, everything that you remember that we said, because this is the eve of Pesach. So now we are finishing with the chametz. From now on, we won't have chametz, because this is the time, this is the time that we stop with the chametz. So now we cleanse ourselves from the chametz, we put everything with all of the crumbs that we have, we clean the place, all of the crumbs, we put it in the toilet, we flush it, or we take it out. So no chametz is in our property. So besiyata dishmaya, then we say kol chamira, kol every chametz, which means any type of leaven, chametz, that may still be in my possession, that I have not seen or not removed, or I don't know about it, Vesiyata Dishmaya is considered nullified and ownerless like the dust of the earth, which means kol chametz usor nimtzeim berashuti shelo gilitiv velo be'artiv velo yedativ sheivutal v'yefker ke'afar ha'aretz b'siyata dishmaya. And this means not only the physical chametz that we have, but also the chametz that we have in our hearts, the loving that we have in our hearts. If it's anger, if it's jealousy, any character attribute that is not so good, b'siyata dishmaya, this is what we need to do, to leva'er et hachametz. B'siyata dishmaya, you know, when we do physically burning the chametz on Friday, so when we do next week, Friday, when we burn the chametz, we can also just put inside the burning of the chametz to ask for Hashem that all of the character traits that we have that are not so good, that Hashem will burn them with this chametz, and Bezrat Hashem turn them to good character traits, Bezrat Hashem, in order that we will elevate our soul, B'siyata Dishmaya, and be closer to Hashem, B'siyata Dishmaya. So this is on Shabbat. Furthermore, Bezrat Hashem, so we spoke about, and don't forget again to sell the chametz. Everything that you buy, I'm just reminding you, kosher for Pesach, check it very carefully. We have three kinds of matzah, Bezrat Hashem. We have three kinds of matzah. We have a regular matzah, we have a matzah shmura, a kept matzah, and we have matzat mitzvah, and a matzah of mitzvah. What is the difference? The difference is when the rabbis are looking, b'siyata dishmaya, on the wheat that is growing, on the grains that are growing. So a regular matzah, b'siyata dishmaya, is kept and watched from the moment that the grains are grind. So the moment that we grind the grains, b'siyata dishmaya, from this moment they are looking after it to see that no moist will come to it, in order that the matzah will be kosher. The shmura matzah, b'siyata dishmaya, is the matzah when the harvest starts. From there they keep they send scholars to watch over all of the process of harvesting, and where they put the harvest, in order to see that no moist will come to it, and b'siyata dishmaya, from there, this is matzah shmura. And the third matzah is matzah mitzvah. Matzah mitzvah is the matzah that we prepare on the eve of Pesach. This time, this year, it's Tavshin Pei Aleph, this year, 781. This year, b'siyata dishmaya, is the year that Pesach is Motzei Shabbos. So b'siyata dishmaya, we can't do it on Shabbat, so they do it on Friday. So on Thursday night, between when the sun goes down and before the stars come up, they go and they take from a spring or from a nachal barach li Hashem, they take water, cold water. They keep it for 12 hours in a cold place, and with this water, they prepare the matzah on the eve of Pesach. So this time it will be on Friday. A special matzah in order to eat it, b'siyata dishmaya, on the first 2 days of Pesach, for us, for first 2 days, because we are not in the land of Israel. In Israel, it's the first day, b'siyata dishmaya. It's good to eat matzah shmura, that made by hand, because even matzah regila and regular matzah and matzah shmura, it can be made by a factory and it can be made by hand. Better to eat, b'siyel, to try to eat matzot that were made by hand, b'ezrat Hashem, and you know every time that they prepare, b'ezrat Hashem, the matzah, they say l'shem mitzvat matzah b'ezrat Hashem. So b'siyata dishmaya, may we all b'ezrat Hashem iskeh to fulfill this holiday b'ezrat Hashem with a happy heart and a kosher holiday b'ezrat Hashem. Furthermore, b'siyata dishmaya, I would like to remind you, on the eve, which is for us is on Friday, we prepare everything on Friday for the seder. everything. You prepare the kara, the plate for Pesach, on Friday, which means on Thursday you start preparing everything, all of the food that you want to make, everything is finished. You put it in the refrigerator because you cannot prepare for Shabbat, so you have to prepare it before. You can put everything in the kara, in the plate, just wrap it and put it in the refrigerator, and then Motzei Shabbos, Besiyata Dishmaya, you can't take out and start doing things before you say Baruch HaMavdil Ben Kodesh Lechol. Don't forget to say that without Shem U'Malchut, because when we do Be'ezrat Hashem, when we start the Haggadah and we are going to bless over the first cup, then we'll do the Havdalah. It includes the first cup. So what happened is the first cup, we bless over the first cup, we say Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam Borei Pri HaGeven, which this Motzei Shabbat, because the Havdalah, we have to do also Havdalah Motzei Shabbat, so we don't do Psamim. Inside the Haggadah, when we read from the Haggadah, you'll see that the father of the house, the one that is reading the Haggadah B'Siyata Dishmaya, he will say Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam Borei Me'orei HaEsh, which means he will look at the candles that he lit for Yom Tov. We don't look at our fingers, we just look at the candles, and then this is Me'orei HaEsh. And the second thing is he will say Baruch, before we say all of this, is before we say Shechianu, after we bless, we said the bracha over Borei Pri HaGefen, then we say Me'orei HaEsh. Then we say, Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, HaMavdil Ben Kodesh Lechol, Uben Or Lechoshech, Uben Yisrael Amim, Uben Yom Hashvi Leseshet Yemei HaMaaseh, Ben Kedushat Shabbat LeYom Tov. We say the Havdalah, which means that Hashem distinguishes between the holiness of Shabbat and the holiness of Yom Tov, and the holiness of Shabbat and the holiness of the 6 days of the week, B'Siyata Dishmaya, and that he sanctifies the children of Israel. And then we say Baruch Ata Hashem HaMavdil Ben Kodesh Lechol, and then we say in the Haggadah Shechiyanu V'Kiyimanu V'Hagiyanu Lazman Hazeh. So the first cup, after we say the bracha over the first cup, after that we say the Havdalah, and then we say Shechiyanu. It's in between the bracha for Borei Pri HaGefen, and Shechiyanu is the Havdalah. So because this is Motzei Shabbos, so B'Siyata Dishmaya, this is the place of it. I would like to remind you that on the eve of Pesach, which means a Friday, don't forget B'Siyata Dishmaya, cutting nails, about brushing your teeth. Anyway, we're going to eat chametz because we have the meals of Shabbat. So we are going to eat chametz on the first meal, the second meal. The third meal, we are not eating chametz. And we're going to eat fish or meat, B'Siyata Dishmaya, fruits on the third meal, because we already took away all of the chametz after the second meal. So B'Siyata Dishmaya, then after the second meal, we need to clean our teeth. So you can clean your teeth from chametz by eating an apple, eating fruits in order to clean the teeth. The rabbis say you can have a brush, you know, the brushes for Shabbat, but you can't put toothpaste on it. And don't touch the gums, so they won't, chas v'shalom, be blood. And if you're afraid to touch the gums, do it with fruits. Just to see, and wash your mouth with water so you won't have chametz inside your teeth. B'Siyata Dishmaya. Furthermore, it's good to go to the mikveh. Don't forget to have a haircut. The men have to have a haircut. And why? Because we're starting the counting of the Omer, Be'ezrat Hashem, the second day of Pesach, the second night of Pesach. We are starting the Omer, the counting of the Omer, until Shavuot. So there's no haircut. So please don't forget to remind your sons, to remind yourselves, Be'ezrat Hashem. Don't forget to have a candle that you can light, B'Siyata Dishmaya, on Motzei Shabbat, you can light the candles of Yom Tov. So don't forget to put a candle that you can light from light to light on Motzei Shabbos, B'Ezrat Hashem. But you can't do all of these things before you said, because we don't start the Haggadah first, but you have to say Baruch HaMavdil Ben Kodesh Lechol. So B'Siyata Dishmaya first you say that, and after that you can light the candles Be'ezrat Hashem and prepare the table for the Seder Be'ezrat Hashem. Furthermore, B'Siyata Dishmaya on the eve of Pesach. So it's good on the eve of Pesach to read it. Usually it's the men that do that. Seder Korban HaPesach, the way that they prepared the sacrifice of Pesach, and it's usually in the Machzorim, you have it at the beginning of the Machzor. Then after that to read Igeret, Rabbi Shimshon Mostropoli, Alav HaShalom, Zchutot Hagem Alenu, Hashem Yikom Damo. You remember that the Arizal wrote an Igeret, and Rabbi Shimshon Mostropoli, a Igeret that nobody understood, and Hashem gave me the zchut to give you the interpretation of the Igeret that the Arizal wrote, Rabbi Shimshon Mostropoli, B'Siyata Dishmaya, explained, and it's written like this, I will translate, I want to find. Rabbi Shimshon Mostropoli, when he was asleep, it was revealed to him, he was a big mekubal, and he's buried in Ukraine, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu. And B'Siyata Dishmaya, it was explained to him all the secrets of the Igeret that the Arizal wrote. And we went through it, and Bezrat Hashem will send you B'Siyata Dishmaya, so you can do it next week. We'll send you B'Siyata Dishmaya, the lesson. Just listen to the lesson. Once you listen to the lesson and look at everything that is written on the board, then it's like you did it yourself, like you read everything. And it's written at the end of the Igeret, בסוף המאמר כותב, שכל המעיין בסוד הנפלא והנורא הזה על מכונו, that he who reads and learns this Igeret, אפילו פעם אחת בשנה, even once a year, and when I taught it before the 9th of Av, in order that Hashem will atone for all of our sins, אפילו פעם אחת בשנה, even once a year, especially on the eve of Pesach, מובטח לו שינצל באותה שנה מכל מכשול וממיתה משונה, that it's promised to him that he will be saved from anything that is not good and from death. ושום אדם לא ימשול בו, and nobody can control him, וכל אויביו יפלו תחתיו, and all of his enemies are going to fall under him, והוא על הבמותמו ידרוך. And he, בסייעתא דשמיא, his hands will be above everyone. ובכל אשר יפנה יצליח, and he's going to have success in everything that he will do, and ובכל הסדקיו ירוויח, and he will have success in all of his business, and בסייעתא דשמיא, עד ביאת הגואל אמן סלע, until Mashiach is here. This is a big promise. So בסייעתא דשמיא, we read סדר קורבן הפסח, we read Igeret Rabbi Shimshon Mostropolia, and we'll send you the lessons in Hebrew and in English. And we read also Seder Membet HaMasaot, the 42 travels that the children of Israel had in the desert. All of this B'Siyata Dishmaya is to open the year. You remember Nisan is the first month, is the head of the months by the Torah. And you remember that we bless every month of the year, which means in the month of Nisan we're blessing the whole year. The whole year that is coming in front of us. So by the Torah, Be'ezrat Hashem. So B'Siyata Dishmaya, all of this is on the eve of Pesach. Furthermore, Be'ezrat Hashem, I would like to remind you that on Shabbat, Chol HaMoed, on Shabbat of Pesach, which means the next Shabbat, Be'ezrat Hashem, I wrote it over here. Next Shabbat, B'Siyata Dishmaya, on Pesach we read Shir HaShirim. So Shabbat, not the next Shabbat, which is Motzei Shabbat is Pesach, but the Shabbat after that, we read the Megillah of Shir HaShirim that King Solomon wrote. I'm reminding you there are five Megillot, and all the five we read them in the holidays. One of them, Sukkot, we read the Megillah of Kohelet. Purim, we read Megillat Esther. On Pesach, we read Shir HaShirim. And Shavuot, we read B'siyat HaDishma Megillat Rut. B'tish'a Be'av, on the 9th of Av, we read Megillat Eicha. So Be'ezrat Hashem, we read Shir HaShirim on Pesach. So, because Motzei Shabbat is a Pesach, the next week on Shabbat, we read Shir HaShirim Be'ezrat Hashem. On Shabbat itself. B'siyat HaDishma, I'm reminding you that on Tfilat Musaf, on the first day of Pesach, the first day of Pesach, Tfilat Musaf, on Musaf, we bless over the tal, over the dew. So girls, don't forget, we say Bimkom Meshiva Ruach Umurida Geshem, we say after that, Murida Tal. So don't forget the first day of Pesach, which means Sunday morning, b'musaf, they already bless b'siyat ha'dishmaya morid atal over the dew, and we start b'ezrat Hashem to say morid atal instead of saying meshiv haruach u'morid ha'geshem. And furthermore, b'siyat ha'dishmaya, the second night of Pesach, b'ezrat Hashem, we start the Omer. On the first day of Pesach, in Eretz Israel, and on the 2 days of Pesach outside the borders of Eretz Israel, we say the whole Hallel. When we go Bechol HaMoed Bezrat Hashem, and on Shvi'i VePesach, and Bechutz Laretz, outside of the borders of the land of Israel Bezrat Hashem, also the 8th day of Pesach, the whole time we say Chatzi Hallel, like we say on Rosh Chodesh, a skipped Hallel. But the first day of Pesach in the land of Israel and the two first days of Pesach outside the land of Israel, we say the whole Hallel. Why we say Chatzi Hallel on Chol HaMoed? Because of the 7th day of Pesach, when the Egyptians were drowned, the 7th day of Pesach is the splitting of the sea. And the Egyptians were drowned in the sea. So the Malachim, the angels, were asking Hashem, Hashem, why don't they say, let the children of Israel say Shira, say Hallel in front of you. And he says, my creation is drowning, they can't say. So they have to skip and say half of the Hallel. So B'siyat HaDishmaya, so in order not to have the whole weeks to say a full Hallel and have an exception on the 7th day of Pesach, that means like the Chol HaMoed will be a higher level than the 7th day of Pesach, which is the 7th day of Pesach is a big day. So our sages said to say a skipped Hallel, like we say on Rosh Chodesh, on all of these days, including the 7th day of Pesach and outside the borders of Israel, the 8th day of Pesach is included. B'siyat HaDishmaya. I'm reminding you the 7th day of Pesach, Be'ezrat Hashem. The men are learning Torah the whole night. And in the morning, B'siyat HaDishmaya, they start Shacharit and they go and they say, Az Yashir Be'ezrat Hashem, next to water, B'siyat HaDishmaya. And we also, Be'ezrat Hashem, say Az Yashir, women, dear ladies, Be'ezrat Hashem, with a happy heart. And we know it's written, Be'ezrat Hashem, that Benisan in the Nigalu, Benisan Nigalu Avotenu, Mimitzrayim, Benisan Atidim Hem Nigal. From in the month of Nisan, our forefathers of, and our fathers were redeemed from Mitzrayim. Hashem took them out of Egypt. And also in Nisan, we're going to see redemption, Be'ezrat Hashem. And that's why it's written in Micha the prophet, Ki meitzetcha meretz Mitzrayim arenu niflot. It's about this exile. It's like from the time of Egypt, I'm going to show you wonders in this exile. B'siyata d'ishma b'mera b'yameinu amen. Dear ladies, let's continue. Just I want to show, we are coming now, Be'ezrat Hashem, to the plate. So I'm showing you the plate by the Arizal. This is the plate, the way Arizal places everything on the plate, and we see Besiyata Dishmaya, this plate is placed by the 10 counts of the Kabbalah. And it starts Bezrat Hashem. First of all, it's beautiful that King David, Amelech David, in Tehillim chapter 26, verse 6, gives us a hint, Bezrat Hashem, for all of the ingredients on the plate. It's written over there, Erchatz benikayon kapai vesoveva et mizbachecha Hashem. So it's written, Besiyata Dishmaya, that I will... I wash my hands in purity, and I'm going to circle around your altar, Hashem. And the altar has all of the ingredients of the plate. Because Mizbachecha, the mem of Mizbachecha of the altar, mem is matzot, it's, you see, matzot is mem, and maror is mem. Maror is mem. Then we have the zayin, the zroah, the steak bone, shake bone, slicha. The shake bone, this is a zroah. And then the bet is for beitza, it's for the egg. We'll speak about it in a minute. The bet is for the beitza, and the chet is for the charoset. You see, the chet is charoset and chazeret. And then we have the chaf. Chaf is karpas. So we have everything hinted in King David's Tehillim, chapter 26, verse 6. Your altar, Mizbachecha, Besiyata Dishmaya. The Tzemach Tzedek says a beautiful thing about the Kara, and we'll speak about it in a minute. First of all, let's go, Bezrat Hashem, to the Gimel Matzot. We have three Matzot. We have one above the other. And you know that Afikoman is from the middle Matzah, Shanachnu Yosim Yachatz. We break the middle Matzah. One is two parts. One is bigger than the other. One, the bigger part is like a Vav, and the smaller part is like a dalet, Besiyata Dishmaya, and this we eat, it's called a fikoman, and Besiyata Dishmaya, we hide it for the children because we want them to be awakened and to ask questions about the Haggadah in order that we can teach them, because this is one of this is mitzvah d'oraita, so we can tell them the story of the Haggadah. Besiyata Dishmaya, banot yekarot, so... And furthermore, they seek for it. So I'll say, you say, why to seek for it? To seek for it, like to remind them that we took all of the holiness sparks from Egypt and took them out of Egypt when we went out of Egypt, Bezrat Hashem. And furthermore, when we finish the Seder, before we say Birkat HaMazon, we eat a small part of the Afikoman, Bezrat Hashem. Why? In order that we'll have the taste of the matzah with us, and remember that the afikoman, it's good for parnasa, so it's usually people save it for the whole year. Oh, bi'ur chametz, I knew I needed to tell you another thing. Bi'ur chametz, don't forget Besiyata Dishmaya, when you burn the chametz, to put over there the lulav and the oshanot. You remember that we save it in order to lever the chametz on Friday next week, to take the lulav, to take the hoshanot Bezrat Hashem, Besiyata Dishmaya, also Chanukah's ptilot, when we put the oil and we put the thing inside in order to light the oil. So if you gathered all of this is the time also, Bezrat Hashem, the week. It's also Besiyata Dishmaya, we burn it with a chametz, and also the afikoman from last year, we burn it with a chametz. Now we have a new afikoman on the Seder, Bezrat Hashem. So let's continue. We have three matzot. The first matzah is for the count of the sfira of chokhmah, of wisdom. The second matzah is for the count of binah, of understanding. And the third one is for knowing, Bezrat Hashem. All of these are three. These are kli, a vessel. What is the vessel? The vessel, kli, chaf lamed yun, kohanim leviim v'Yisrael, parallel to kohanim, parallel to the leviim, and parallel to Israel. Parallel to our three forefathers, Abraham, Yitzchak, v'Yaakov. Parallel, Besiyata Dishmaya, for the nefesh, for the three parts of the soul, the neshama, the ruach, and the nefesh. Parallel to the three triple blessing of the kohanim, which is Yevarkecha, Vesiyata Dishmaya, Er Veisa. So we have, it's parallel to this. All of this is the three matzot Besiyata Dishmaya. Then we have the Beitza. We have first, let's go to the shake bone. So we have the shake bone, it's a Zroa, Bezrat Hashem, to remind us, Besiyata Dishmaya, the sacrifice of Pesach. So this is parallel to the count of Chesed. And then we have the Beitza, the egg. This is parallel to judgment, to Gvura. And we know that the more that our sages say, egg, the Korban Chagiga. Every high holiday, Besiyata Dishmaya, they used to bring to the temple, Korban Chagiga, the sacrifice of celebrating Besiyata Dishmaya. So this is Korban Chagiga. Furthermore, it's this. Our sages say it's like the character traits of the children of Israel, that the more you boil the egg, the harder it gets, which means the more we have suffering, we become stronger, and Besiyata Dishmaya united, and we are just like one people, Bezrat Hashem, and nobody can break the children of Israel. Once we have bitachon, faith and bitachon in Hashem. Furthermore, Besiyata Dishmaya, the egg is round, so it reminds us that the ruining of the temple, you know that when a person is mourning, you give him a round things to eat when he comes from the Beit HaChaim, Besiyata Dishmaya. So this reminds us the ruining of the temple, Besiyata Dishmaya. Now we go to the Maror. Maror is in order to remind us of the suffering of the children of Israel by the Egyptians. So this is usually, this comes parallel to the Tiferet. And you see, we have a shake bone, an egg, and Maror. Remember, this is Chesed. The Chesed is mercy, it's parallel to Avraham Avinu. Gvura is judgment, parallel to Yitzchak Avinu. And Tiferet Besiyata Dishmaya, which is beauty, is parallel to Yaakov Avinu. So Besiyata Dishmaya, we take a green vegetable for the Maror Besiyata Dishmaya, and we come from here to Netzach. Netzach is under Chesed. Over here, it's the Charoset. And we know that the charoset, we make the charoset from nuts, tzimukim, raisins, and apples, and dates, in order to remind us how we made the bricks. You remember Pharaoh said that he wants them to make the bricks, not only they won't get the materials to make the bricks, but they will have to gather them. So this is the charoset, Besiyata Dishmaya, and this is parallel to Netzach, which is eternity, victory and eternity. This is Netzach. Then we come to the Karpas. The Karpas, Besiyata Dishmaya, is under the Beitza, under the egg, and it's parallel to Hod, which is a glory. Spend the glory. This is Karpas, Hod over here. And I would like to remind you, Netzach is Moshe Rabbeinu. Hod Besiyata Dishmaya is Aaron HaKohen, Besiyata Dishmaya, and with the Karpas Bezrat Hashem is green lettuce or parsley, we use it over here, and then we come to the Chazeret, which is foundation, this is the Yesod, which is the middle line we see over here, Bezrat Hashem, it comes under the Tiferet, this is the Chazeret, which is grind horseradish, over here, and the kara itself and the plate itself is parallel to Malchut, to kingdom. And I want to show you, Bezrat Hashem, Atzemach Tzadik says a beautiful thing about it. Why do we raise the kara? Why do we raise the kara? Because when we raise the letters of kara, which means what comes after, kara is plate, what comes after the kuf in the Hebrew Aleph Bet comes Reish. What comes after Ayin comes Pei. What comes after Reish comes Shin. What comes after He comes Vav. So together these letters are Shofar. So just like Besiyata Dishmaya on Rosh Hashanah, we blow the Shofar in order that Hashem will take off judgment from the children of Israel and move from the chair of judgment to the chair of mercy, Besiyata Dishmaya. This is Be'ezrat Hashem. When we eat the matzah Be'ezrat Hashem, we take judgment that there won't be judgment on Rosh Hashanah for the children of Israel. And not only for the children of Israel, because what we do influences the whole world. So B'siyata Dishmaya, this is the Kara. And with this Be'ezrat Hashem, I would like to bench all of us that we will have Pesach Kasher V'Sameach. Remember that when Hashem took the children of Israel out of Egypt, after showing them the miracles of the 10 plagues above nature, B'siyata Dishmaya, and opened the ocean in 12 paths for them above nature, B'siyata Dishmaya, and walked them in the desert for 50 days. On the 50th day, they received the Torah, Be'ezrat Hashem. Hashem made a treaty with the children of Israel. They were his firstborns, and now, B'siyata Dishmaya, they had a treaty. The Torah came to this world. They received it in order that they can elevate this world to a higher place, and this world will be ready to accept, B'ezrat Hashem, Mashiach Tzidkenu B'mira B'yameinu Amen. So I would like to bench all of us, B'ezrat Hashem. Don't forget that there's no tachanun, no espedim, no fasting, B'siyata Dishmaya. So B'siyata Dishmaya, I would like to bench all of us that we will all greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Barachamim B'mira B'yameinu Amen. Eliyahu Navi Zechur Latov. L'olam Yipared Adam Mechaverov B'ivar Alachei Yachid V'Rabim Alacha K'Rabim. עלינו בטוב ותקיצו בישועה ורחמים. בעזרת השם, סליחה.